Okay, so we're on the car top here. I made the switch already. So here was the P3 door zone. You can see now it's P3 door zone. All I did was flip them. They look good. I'll insert a picture here of what they look like, right? And then you can use this here to determine what terminal was what. I flipped the door zone with the P3, or sorry, I didn't flip. There's nothing on the P3, so I moved my, what was it, 25 it looks like? Yeah, 25, I moved from door zone to P3. But also, too, if we compare these two guys, see here, like, this could be a huge part of the problem too. Look at the wear on those, and both top guides, so like the other one here, like look at that. Sorry about the picture, but so I think I might run to a boat that's in dry dock here and take them off and put them on, like, go snag two of these, like these holders, and put them on here, because that one other one's in there for like 2 months and we can get that shit down to them. But I gotta make a call. But that's like, if you look at that compared to that, like even that one is worn. Oh, so those are the two top ones. Here's one bottom one and one top one. That's our problem. Okay, let's put her back together so I can make the decision whether I'm going to get one or not. Okay, so we have to excuse the noise, but we're down here in the controller. So here's our kind of dummy lights for the LUDZ door zone 1 and LEV. So level up, level down. Here's our relays for the door zone. As you can see, the crew's been going through some shit. But I've just been running in here, right, from the controller. And watching to see if I lose any of these coming into the floor. So these should come on here in a second. There we go. Then watching door locks. We got the indicator lights here, so as soon as the door locks come back online, now how I got to the tape head, this is the fault we were getting. Door zone sensor remained active, activated out of the leveling zone. So what I did is I took the worn shoes off the top of that tape head. It was doing this fault at the top floor almost every 5 trips. And getting like, so you'd have to come down and do a manual reset and everything. So I switched the worn shoes from the top of the tape head to the bottom, as well as the sensor. And now I have it happening once every 20 trips at the bottom. And it's not getting locked up to a manual reset. It's coming out of itself, its own fault, in like, you know, in like 6-7 seconds of sitting there, it clears itself and you can continue on. So I think I gotta go get those shoes. But we're making progress.
Okay, so remember in a previous video, this is the one I rebuilt here, the cam setup, right? but I'm here to take the shoes off of that tape reader there. It's a little tough to see with the light, but let me get those off. And then this boat's now in dry dock. I'll show you before I take off, but it's going to be here for a couple months, so gives me lots of time to get the right thing. And this guy, these will allow me to get the other one running right away. So just hang on. Okay. So as you can see, I've left the tape head where it is. So there's no need to figure that shit out when I get back or someone gets back. Here's one, which are in much better condition. And the same with that one. So, I'm leaving the elevator on. Sorry, just bear with me for a sec. I'm leaving the elevator on inspection with the stop button on and stuff, because they're just working here in dry dock. So, there's the old one with the vertical C. Let me just turn this on open. But yeah, kind of one of those rob Peter to pay Paul situations, but that's where we're at. So we gotta hurry up and get back to the other boat before I miss the crossing for lunch.